Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen the voltage series feedback topology of the feedback amplifier. So similarly, in this video, we will learn about the voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So if you see the basic topology of the voltage shunt feedback amplifier, then it consists of the basic transimpedance amplifier and the feedback network. So in this feedback topology, the input signal is applied as the current source, and the output of this feedback amplifier is the voltage signal. So here, this output voltage signal is sampled using the feedback network. And on the input side, since we have the current source as an input signal, so it is mixed with that input current with the shunt feedback. That means in this feedback topology, we have a voltage sampling and the shunt mixing. And that is why this type of feedback amplifiers are known as the voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So as you can see, in this feedback topology, the connection of the feedback network to the basic amplifier is via the shunt connection. That means both on input and output side, it is connected via the shunt connection. And that is why sometimes this topology is also known as the shunt-shunt feedback. And sometimes this topology is also referred as the voltage current feedback. Because on the output side or on the sampling side, we are sampling the voltage signal, while on the mixing side or on the input side, we are mixing the current signal. So these are the alternate namings for the voltage shunt feedback topology. So previously, we have seen that this topology is mainly suited for the transimpedance feedback amplifier. Because here, the input signal is the current signal, while the output signal is the voltage signal. And here, since we have the shunt connection on the output side, so the effective output impedance of the feedback amplifier will reduce. And similarly on the input side, since we have a shunt connection, so the input impedance of this feedback amplifier will also reduce by the factor of 1 plus A beta. Where here, this A is the gain of the basic transimpedance amplifier, and this beta is the feedback factor of this feedback network. So now, let us see that in this topology, how the input and output impedance reduces, and how we got these expressions. So this is the ideal structure of the voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So here, this A circuit shows the basic transimpedance amplifier block, while this beta circuit shows the ideal feedback block. So here, this RI is the input impedance of the basic amplifier, and this II is the input current. And similarly on the output side, this input current II is getting amplified by the gain of this amplifier. And then, we will get the voltage as a output. Now here, if you see the unit for this transimpedance amplifier gain, then it will be in the ohms. Because here, the output is the voltage signal, while the input is the current signal. And here, this R0 is the output impedance of the basic amplifier. So here, this feedback network samples the output voltage Vout, and it provides the feedback current IF. So as you can see, at the input node, this feedback current IF is getting subtracted from the source signal. So here, for the simplicity, it has been assumed that the input current source is the ideal current source. That means its source impedance is equal to infinite. And similarly, for the simplicity, here this load resistor RL is also not connected on the output side. Moreover, here it has been assumed that this feedback network is ideal and it does not load the basic amplifier. That means here, after connecting the feedback network, the output of the basic amplifier will not change. That means in this feedback network, if we remove the mixing side connection, then just because of the voltage sampling, the output of the basic amplifier is not changing. So with this consideration, now let us find the effective input impedance of this voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So here, the effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier is the impedance which is seen through this current source. That means here, if we take the ratio of this voltage across the current source to this current source IS itself, then that will be the effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier. So here, because of the shunt connection, the voltage across the current source is same as the VI. So we can say that over here, this VI divided by IS will be the effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier. Let's say that is equal to RIF. And now, let us find the relationship between this VI and the IS. So here, if we apply the KCL on this input node, then we can write this IS minus IF that is equal to II. And as you can see over here, this IF is equal to beta times V naught. So we can say that this IS minus this beta times V naught that is equal to II. Or we can say that this IS is equal to II plus this beta times V naught. So here, this output voltage V out is equal to A times II. So we can say that is equal to II plus this A times beta times II. Or we can say that this current IS is equal to II times this 1 plus A beta. And here, as you can see, this II is equal to VI divided by RI. So further, we can write it as this IS is equal to VI divided by RI times 1 plus A beta. Or we can say that this VI divided by IS that is equal to RI divided by 1 plus A beta. So from this, we can say that the effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier is equal to RI divided by this 1 plus A beta. So in this way, because of the shunt connection, the effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier reduces. So similarly, now let us find the effective output impedance of this feedback amplifier. So here, to find the output impedance, we will consider all the independent sources in the circuit as 0. That means here, this current source will act as a open circuit. And here, we will apply the test voltage on the output side. So let's say this test voltage is equal to Vx. So here, this effective output impedance, which is seen through this test voltage, is equal to Vx divided by Ix. That means here, this effective output impedance or this ROF is equal to Vx divided by Ix. So now let us see how to find that. So here, now since test voltage is sampled, so here this voltage will be equal to Vx. And now this feedback current If is equal to beta times Vx. And here, now we apply the KCL at this input node. Then as you can see, now this IF is equal to minus II. So further we can write it as this beta times Vx is equal to minus II. So now let us apply the KVL equation on the output side. So if we apply the KVL equation, then we can write this Vx is equal to this R0 times Ix plus A times II, where this A is the transimpedance gain of this basic amplifier. So now, further we can write this expression as this R0 times Ix minus A times beta times Vx, because here this II is equal to minus beta times Vx. So now, if we take this term on the left hand side, then further we can write it as this Vx times 1 plus A beta that is equal to this R0 times Ix. Or we can say that this Vx divided by Ix is equal to this R0 divided by this 1 plus A beta. That means now this effective output impedance ROF is equal to R0 divided by this 1 plus A beta. So as you can see, because of the shunt connection, this effective output impedance of this feedback amplifier is reducing by the factor of 1 plus A beta. So in this way, because of the shunt connection both on the input and output side, the input and output impedance of this feedback amplifier reduces. And this is how the equivalent circuit of the feedback amplifier will look like, where this RIF is the effective input impedance, while this ROF is the effective output impedance. And this AF is the closed loop gain of the feedback amplifier. So here if you see, then the reduction in both input and output impedance is a desired thing for the transimpedance amplifier. Because in the transimpedance amplifier, when we connect the current source as an input, then it will also have some source resistance. So we want that the maximum current should reach to the amplifier, and it will happen whenever this RI is much less than RS. That means if the input impedance is much less than the source resistance, then the maximum current will flow through this RI. And in that case, this IS dash is approximately equal to IS. So in this voltage shunt feedback amplifier, since the input impedance is reducing with the feedback, so that is the desired thing for the transimpedance amplifier. Similarly, if you see the output side of the transimpedance amplifier, then it will also have the load resistor. So in this case, if you see the actual voltage that is reaching to the load or this VOL, then that is equal to this RL divided by this RL plus R0 times this A times IS dash. So here we will get the more output voltage across the load resistor whenever this R0 is much less than RL. So in this feedback topology, since the output voltage is also reducing, so that is the desired thing for the transimpedance amplifier. So in short, we can say that when the feedback amplifier is used in this voltage shunt feedback topology, then both input and output impedance of the feedback amplifier reduces. Alright, so now let us see in the actual circuits how this voltage shunt feedback is implemented. So in this voltage shunt feedback, the output voltage is sampled and then it is sent back to the input side as a feedback current. So in the actual circuits, the one way to achieve the voltage to current conversion is using the transistor. So as you can see over here, the output voltage of the amplifier is applied to the gate terminal of the MOSFET. That means here, this VGS is equal to Vout. And as you know, according to this voltage VGS, the drain current that is flowing through the MOSFET will change. Or we can say that this feedback current IF is directly related to this VGS. Or in other words, it is directly related to this output voltage. So here, with the increase in the output voltage, this voltage VGS will increase. And due to the increase in the voltage VGS, this drain current ID or this feedback current IF will also increase. And because of that, now the net current II that is flowing into the basic amplifier will reduce. And because of that, this Vout will also reduce. So in this way, using the MOSFET, it is possible to provide the negative feedback and it is possible to perform the voltage sampling and the current mixing. So when we use the transistor in the feedback circuit, then it is basically an active component. But typically in the feedback network, the passive components are used so that the value of the feedback components or this feedback factor does not change with the change in the external parameters. So as a passive element, we can even use a resistor for this voltage to current conversion in the feedback network. That means this feedback resistor can be connected between the output node and the input current source. So in this case, this feedback current IF is equal to Vx minus this Vout divided by RF, where this Vx is the voltage at this node. So if this Vx is very small, then as you can see, this feedback current IF is directly proportional to the output voltage. And in this way, just using the feedback resistor, it is possible to perform the voltage sampling and the current mixing. So based on that, now let us see the few circuits where this voltage shunt feedback is implemented. So now, if you see this circuit, then the feedback topology of the given circuit is the voltage shunt feedback. Because here, through the MOSFET, the output voltage is sampled and the drain terminal of this MOSFET is connected to the input current source. So here, this feedback current IF is the current that is flowing through the MOSFET. That means here, through the MOSFET, we have a voltage sampling and the current mixing. So similarly, this is another example of the voltage shunt feedback. So here, instead of the transistor, using a resistor as a passive element, the output voltage is sampled and it is sent as a feedback current to the input side. So here, since the feedback component is directly connected to the output node, so it is sampling the voltage. And on the input side, we have the current mixing. So here, to use this circuit as an amplifier, the only thing that we need to check is whether there is a negative feedback in the circuit or not. So here, the current that is going into the source terminal of the M1 is equal to IS minus IF. So if the source current increases, then this current will also increase. And because of that, the drain current ID which is flowing through the MOSFET M1 will reduce. So due to the reduction in this drain current, the drop across the RD1 will also reduce. And because of that, the output of this M1 will increase. So now, this output of the M1 will go to the gate terminal of the M2. That means now, this VGS2 will increase. And as you know, as the VGS increases, then the drain current ID will also increase. So we can say that for this MOSFET M2, the drain current ID2 will increase. So this increase in the drain current will also increase the drop across the RD2. And because of that, this output voltage Vout will reduce. And here, this feedback current IF is the voltage difference between this node and the output voltage Vout divided by RF. So here, as the Vout reduces, so this current IF will increase. And because of that, now the current that is going into the M1 will reduce. So here, since the IS and IF have the same polarity, or in other words, since they are changing in the same direction, so we can say that the given feedback is the negative feedback. And indeed, this is the example of the voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So similarly, this is the another example of the voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So here, the one end of the feedback resistor is connected to the output node, and the other end of the resistor is connected to the source current at the input side. So here, since the one end of the feedback component is directly connected to the output voltage, so it means that it is sampling the output voltage. And as you can see, this feedback resistor is connected to the input current source via the shunt connection. So we can say that this circuit is the example of the voltage shunt feedback topology. So similarly, this is the transimpedance amplifier using the op-amp. And here, once again, it is the example of the voltage shunt feedback. So here, this feedback resistor RF is connected between the output and the inverting node. So here, if you see the feedback current IF, then roughly it is equal to minus Vout divided by RF. Because here, the inverting node of the op-amp will act as a virtual ground. And here, the input current to the op-amp will be very small. So we can say that this IS is equal to IF, and that is equal to minus Vout divided by RF. And if we see the transimpedance gain of this feedback circuit, or this Vout divided by IS, then that is equal to minus RF. So similarly, this inverting op-amp configuration of the op-amp is also example of the voltage shunt feedback. But you might ask, in the voltage shunt feedback, we have a current source as an input, right? So how this circuit will act as a voltage shunt feedback? So here, if you see this voltage source and the resistor, then using the source transformation, it can be converted into the current source. And here, this IS is equal to VS divided by R1. So that is why this is also example of the voltage shunt feedback. Similarly, this common source amplifier where a drain feedback is used, it is also example of the voltage shunt feedback. Because here, once again using the source transformation, this voltage source can be converted into the current source. And once again, here this IS is equal to VS divided by RS. So these are the few examples of the voltage shunt feedback topology. So I hope in this video, you understood how in this voltage shunt feedback topology, both input and output impedance reduces, and how in the actual circuits, this feedback is implemented. So similarly, in the next video, we will learn about the current series feedback topology. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.